When you change the metaphor, when you unpack it and change it, everything changes, and in a good way. One of the most interesting language tools, apart from the meta model and the Milton model, is another one that starts with M, which is the metaphor model of language.
All right, so the metaphor model means, metaphor meaning stories or things that relate to other things.
Or things that stand in for other things.
Yeah, exactly. So what exactly is a metaphor model, and how do people use metaphors, and why do they use metaphors?
Well, this comes from Dr. David Grove's Clean Language, and he was a psychologist. He's no longer with us, but he brilliantly discovered that when we talk as human beings, we make sense of the world by talking about things we already know and grafting mm-hmm. them into the conversation. In other words, we bring in metaphors in our conversation every 6 to 10 seconds.
Yeah, we do it a lot,
right? There's like buses. Another one will come along any
minute. Something like 6 metaphors per minute,
yeah,
I believe.
That's right. I said every 6 to 10 seconds.
It'd be interesting to review this video and see how many we actually throw in accidentally.
Yes, accidentally.
People throw these in all the time.
Oh, throw!
There's
throw.
One right there.
Because you can't actually throw them. So you say, what kind of throw mm-hmm. is throw the metaphor? Anyway, we'll show you how to unpack them.
We'll talk first, though. So why do people use metaphor? Why do we do that?
It's the natural way we process the world. Mm-hmm. That's why we say things like, oh, that really hits the nail on the
right.
head. You know, we just...
Our brains are very good at learning something and then using that something to connect to something else. In fact, connect is, there's another metaphor. You'll think, oh, Lego blocks or something like that.
Right.
Or you might think a logical wire, when in reality, inside my brain, it's just a bunch of cells.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yes. So amazingly, since we speak in metaphors, when we ask people about their metaphors, it can sound weird, but it can really help them unpack their own model of the world.
And in fact, you can get them to then change their metaphor, the way that they think about their problem.
And they change it naturally on their own. You don't change it
just by asking them questions.
Yeah. I was talking to a woman who was very anxious. And she was sitting there, I was talking to her, and I said something like, so how are things going? And she said, oh, I just feel like I'm in a trap every mm-hmm. day of my life.
There's your metaphor.
There's the clean language question. The metaphor question is, what
kind
of
trap
is that? And she said, it's the kind of trap that hems me in. And she started to unpack this in response to the questions. Now, the key is, when you're unpacking a negative, like a trap, you want to immediately switch to a positive and mm-hmm. say, well, what would you like to have happen instead? And they say, well, I want to be free and mm-hmm. open. What kind of open is it? See, when you unpack the positive, it really helps the person. So they say, you know, I'm feeling much stronger now. What kind of stronger is that? Well, I'm feeling like I could take on the world.
Right.
But if they have a negative, feeling depressed or something, you don't unpack that too much. It'll
so the general rule is if they're describing a negative metaphor, you're going to ask them questions to transform that into something positive. If you're starting with a positive, or once you've moved to something positive, you're going to then ask questions to amplify that feeling state and get better results.
And it's as simple as when you hear a metaphor, asking them about it.
Right. Now, it can be a very annoying thing if you meta meddling.
Yeah.
Is there a, do we have it? We don't need one. We need to come up with a term for
metaphor meddling.
Right. Yeah. So you don't want to be annoying with this.
Right.
But be aware that people are going to speak in metaphor all the time. And if they're in a problem state, or if they just want to improve something really good, and you can get them to elicit the metaphor, you can use language to help transform a bad metaphor into something good.
By asking mm-hmm. them what they would like to have happen, rather than unpacking it. You know, if someone says, I feel like I'm in a prison, and you say, well, what kind of prison is that? Well, it's a dark dungeon. What? Tell me more about mm-hmm. dungeon. Anything else about dungeon? No, that's not the way to go. Mm-hmm. You'll sink them into that despair.
It's the evil way of using clean language.
And we don't believe in that at all.
Call it dirty language.
Nah, evil language. And there's books on this. We recommend two excellent books here. This is Clean Language, and this is David Grove's original stuff Wendy Sullivan and Judy Reese.
We'll give it a nice clean,
clean
view.
Are we getting any glare off
there
of
we
that?
Go. So there's Clean Language, and another one that a lot of people like is Metaphors.
Here, hold it up. Hold it up. Yeah, scary thing goes
metaphors
you.
Metaphors in Mind. So these are two. This one's shorter, obviously, easier read. We would suggest starting with this one. Great book.
Excellent book.
Did you say that you learn more out of it the second time you read it?
Nobody. Mm-hmm. I read this one, Clean Language. I read this. That's pretty interesting. Read it with a highlighter, though. Mm-hmm. Then I read my highlights a second time. And I went, oh, I got more. It was the third time I read it that it all clicked.
Yeah.
And then I found I could use it easily. It's worth it, though. This is life stuff that can give you really, really powerful communication
Before
with other people.
Before we end this video, I want to ask you one question.
What's
we didn't prepare
that, Chris?
This one. How did clean language fall into the map of you creating mindscaping?
Well, mindscaping, you're eliciting what is happening in front of them in their imagination, and clean language enables me to do that without what we call leading the witness.
Right.
You don't want to say, do you see a fence in front of you? No, you're leading the witness. You want to say anything else in front of you. That's clean
they're
language.
In mindscaping, people are creating their own metaphor for the problem.
Right. And then we change the metaphor and the problem goes away. That's why this stuff works, guys. When you change the metaphor, when you unpack it and change it, everything changes, and in a good way.
All right, so I hope you enjoyed that video on clean language and the metaphor model. So if you want to learn more, visit MikeMandaleHypnosis.com. But make sure while you're here, hit that subscribe button, click that bell icon so you're always alerted to our latest videos. Leave us comments and we'll see you in the next video.